I have to say, it's a pretty incredible feeling. Being able to work on a mission that's flying out to the moon, you know, kind of puts you in a really exclusive club, and along with other missions and other folks that have made some of the greatest achievements that mankind has ever accomplished.
NASA going back to the moon is such an insane endeavor. I think they're making history again, and to be a part of it is something that I never thought I would get to experience. Yeah, it's awesome. It's so exciting.
For me, something that I've been particularly proud of throughout this CAPSTONE program is actually seeing all the bits and pieces we'd worked on years ago kind of coming to life in the forms of Pathfinder and PathStone, and being able to see those things happening in space and knowing that we're able to carry that forward into CAPSTONE was really rewarding.
Everyone in the company really dives into a problem, you know, as soon as it comes up, and everyone is looking for a way to contribute, a way to knock out a problem, and a way to make things happen and do it quickly. And I think that that culture has a lot to do with this success that we've had and are going to continue to have.
It's been really impressive watching our own teams go through that development process. In particular, ASI up in Colorado, they specialize in flight software, and we are now using their flight software suite on the Lunar Photon vehicle. So it's been, you know, really helpful and really rewarding watching that process.
I think what makes CAPSTONE so different is that it's so complex, and so much that has to come together. We have insanely tight margins on mass, power, the propulsion performance, so that we make it all the way to the moon. And I haven't seen a system with this strict margins before.
Gone through a lot of challenges throughout the journey, and now we've got the spacecraft down on the pad, ready to go to the moon. And watching the team come together, it's super motivating and super exciting.
I got offered this position, so I had to make a decision. I felt like if I didn't take this opportunity, I would regret it for the rest of my life.
Never crossed my mind that I'd be working in space, let alone, you know, sending something towards the moon and helping the team out and sitting in those seats in mission control. I'm so nervous. Yeah, it really is a pretty different ball game with CAPSTONE versus Electron.
One milestone that I'm particularly proud of and proud of the team for is the development of the Hypercurie. Getting the Hypercurie from sort of concept and design right through to flight is pretty impressive. We're developing an engine that is for deep space. It's really high delta V, a high thrust engine, and we're using green propellants. You know, that's really industry leading stuff. And so we're right at the forefront of industry there. So it's great to see, you know, with that very first time we hot fired that engine, and to see the look on people's faces and the excitement to know that we're one step closer.
All the individuals, all the engineers really attack a problem, and everyone is looking to figure out how can we figure something out, how can we accomplish something.
Bringing people from all ends of the business to ensure the success of this mission has been incredible to watch.
Yeah, I'm just so happy for all the people who have worked so hard on it, and seeing them rewarded for, you know, how far we've come so far.
It's super cool, and I'm never going to look at the moon the same way again.